Kapila, if we may begin this conversation from the basics, for those of us who are not initiated into the Kudiyattam art form, can you give us a glimpse of Kudiyattam art form's origins and perhaps take us through some of its fascinating history?
Kudiyattam is actually one of the only surviving links to the ancient Sanskrit theatre tradition of India. So we believe that at a point of time in our history, Sanskrit literature was flourishing very much, and plays were written, and these plays travelled to various parts of the country, even came down, and it was very much in vogue to perform, or each region of the Indian subcontinent had probably a different way of adapting these plays and producing them. And these plays also traveled south, and it was very, very much, you know, how do you say, appreciated that even in the south there started to be playwrights, even from Kerala, like Shakti Bhadra, and, you know, plays were even written here in the Sanskrit language. So in that way, the Sanskrit theatre was at some point of time in history very much in vogue in India. And Kudiyattam, as we know of it now, is a form that evolved out of trying to produce these Sanskrit dramas that were written. So it's actually, if you look at it, Kudiyattam is a very, very interesting combination of the Margi and the Deshi, of the Sanskrit language and the local culture, and the aesthetics, the body language, the use of hastas, and this very special kind of abhinaya that somehow is influenced by the Natyashastra but not completely, you know, in alliance with it. It's very unique by itself. So it has a long history, and as we know it today, is, I don't know, probably a result of many centuries, but this is basically the story of Kudiyattam.